Welcome to this presentation by the Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering at the University of Maryland. My name is Katherine Weiland, and I am the Acting Director of Undergraduate Studies in the department. Thank you for your interest in our department. We look forward to sharing information about our two academic majors with you. The Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering, or ECE for short, is the second largest academic department in the A. James Clark School of Engineering, and the only department with two academic majors. We have approximately 900 undergraduate students and 400 graduate students. Our size offers a broad range of program and research opportunities. We have a strong partnership with a number of corporate affiliates, which results in excellent internship, research, and employment opportunities for our students. One reason for our strong partnerships is our location in the Washington, Baltimore, and Northern Virginia region, giving access to many public and private companies in the engineering and technology sector. Finally, we are very proud of the talented and diverse community of students, faculty, and staff that make up ECE. ECE sits at the crossroads of many areas and subtopics such as electronics, power systems, signal processing, devices and circuits, control systems, robotics, and embedded systems. As you can see on this slide, electrical and computer engineering are two very broad topics. The diversity of areas and subtopics within ECE help our graduates address the many technologies and recent innovations within our industries. These include computer architecture and systems, sensor and wireless technologies, big data, artificial intelligence and machine learning, and Internet of Things. ECE is proud to have the largest number of faculty members in the Clark School of Engineering. We currently have 61 full tenured and tenure track professors, 30 affiliate faculty members, and 48 research faculty members. Our faculty includes recipients of prestigious awards such as the National Science Foundation's Career Awards. Seven of our faculty members have been designated as distinguished university professors by our institution. Finally, many of our faculty members hold joint appointments with different academic units and research centers, opening up further research and academic opportunities for our students. The ECE department has a research budget of over $30 million. We have a strong research culture within our department, which promotes and encourages research within our undergraduate students. Many ECE students have the opportunity to work as research assistant within faculty members' laboratories. We also provide opportunities for students to earn academic credits for research through our ENEE 499 course. Our ECE students are in high demand in both the internship and job market. Due to their programming experience in both majors, it is not rare for an ECE student to get an internship in the summer after their first year, although most students find an internship in their second summer. Each semester, the ECE department hosts between 40 to 50 companies at our ECE Career Fair. Upon graduation, approximately 90% of computer engineering graduates and 87% of electrical engineering graduates find a job or enroll in graduate school. This slide shows a small sample of the many companies where our students gain internships and employment, from companies with local offices such as Northrop Grumman, Booz Allen Hamilton, and Texas Instruments, to companies on the West Coast such as Google and Microsoft. The next slides will discuss the curriculum of the electrical engineering and computer engineering majors. Here you can see a Venn diagram that gives you a big picture view of both majors, with electrical engineering at the top and computer engineering at the bottom. The diagram is intersected by a line representing a division among hardware and software. As you notice, there are broad topics that are common to both majors, represented here in black letters: circuits, digital logic design, signals and systems, and basic programming. The topics in red letters are those that are unique to the electrical engineering major, which sits above the hardware and software line: advanced electronics, electromagnetism, wave propagation, and device physics. Straddling the hardware-software line is the computer engineering major. Below the hardware-software line, you see topics unique to computer engineering in blue letters: advanced programming, algorithms, computer design, and operating systems. Many of our incoming students often have interest in both electrical engineering and computer engineering. This diagram shows its similarities and differences, and our advising staff can work with you in helping you decide which program to pursue. The first year of both electrical and computer engineering majors consists mainly of math, physics, and programming courses. Students in electrical engineering will take math courses such as Calculus 1, Calculus 2, Differential Equations, and Vector Calculus, also known as Calculus 3. They also take 3 semesters of physics, looking at topics such as mechanics, electricity and magnetism, and relativity, among others, as well as 1 semester of chemistry. They also take ENES 100, Introduction to Engineering Design, a course required of all engineering majors. Additionally, they will take ENEE 101, Introduction to ECE, which is required for all students in our department. Finally, in their first year, electrical engineering majors take 2 semesters of C programming. Computer engineering majors will take some of the same courses with some slight variations. Within math, they take Calculus 1, Calculus 2, and Differential Equations. For their 4th math course, they take a discrete mathematics course, which is relevant for a number of computer science courses in the program. Computer engineering majors only take 2 semesters of physics and 1 semester of chemistry. They also take the same required introductory courses, ENES 100 and ENEE 101. Finally, computer engineering majors take 3 semesters of introductory and intermediate programming in both Java and C languages, among others. Taken mainly during the sophomore and junior years, these foundation courses make up the core of the electrical engineering and computer engineering curriculum. The EEE majors take foundation courses in circuits, computer organization, communication, systems and probability, device physics and technology, digital logic design, and electromagnetics. The courses that make up the electrical engineering curriculum is a mix of theory and laboratory courses, giving students both theoretical and hands-on experiences in the program. In the computer engineering side, you see some similar courses such as circuits, communication systems, digital logic design, and probability. However, the curriculum for CE majors includes algorithms, advanced programming, computer design, and operating systems. As you have noticed, a number of these courses are taught by the computer science department, since the computer engineering program is jointly taught by our department and the computer science department. While the freshman, sophomore, and junior years of the program are made up of mostly required courses, the senior year of the program is designed to give students the opportunity to pursue areas of interest inside and outside the major. Electrical engineering majors take an advanced mathematics elective, up to 3 electrical engineering theory courses in their area of choice, an advanced laboratory course, as well as a capstone course. Additionally, they are able to take 3 courses in the upper-level non-major elective courses. In the computer engineering side, students take 2 additional math and science electives, 1 upper-level computer science theory course, and 2 computer engineering theory courses. Like their EE counterparts, CE majors also take an advanced laboratory course and a capstone design course. They are also able to take 1 upper-level non-major elective. One course that we would like to emphasize during the senior year of each major is the capstone design course. This course serves as the culmination of the electrical or computer engineering major. Students are presented with a real-life problem and are asked to create a solution based on all of their knowledge in each program. Capstone design courses are available on a wide variety of topics such as microprocessors, electric vehicles, software engineering, accelerator physics, electric bikes, optical system design, robotics, digital systems design, multimedia signal processing, and mixed signal VLSI design. As we previously mentioned, during the senior year, our students take a number of theory courses as part of their senior level requirement. Here you can see a sample of the different topics available to our senior electrical and computer engineering majors. We would like to share 3 academic opportunities to incoming students. First, for electrical engineering majors and other engineering majors, we have developed a minor in computer engineering. The minor gives EE and other engineering majors the opportunity to get additional courses in programming and software. For electrical engineering majors, the program would add an additional 3 courses to their curriculum. Computer engineering majors have the opportunity to specialize in cybersecurity. The cybersecurity specialization is built in within the computer engineering major. It just requires students to take specific senior level courses in topics such as reverse engineering, hardware security, and computer system security to complete the specialization. Finally, our newest academic program is the Academy of Machine Learning. AML gives students the opportunity to take additional courses in machine learning. Upon completion of the program, students receive a notation on their transcript indicating their completion of the program. We would like to close our presentation by talking about some of the student support and opportunities we have in our department. Given the complexity of our academic majors, we have required advising meetings each semester for all of our undergraduate students. In the first semester, advising is done through a number of group advising sessions held by academic advisors in our department, given the similarity in courses and questions among first semester students. Starting in the second semester and until graduation, ECE students have an assigned advisor that will work with them throughout the entirety of their tenure in ECE. Advising meetings give students the opportunity to talk to their advisor about their academic progress, discuss any academic challenges, get academic resources, and plan for opportunities such as research, co-op, and study abroad. Another program we want to highlight is our peer mentoring program, which is currently sponsored by Texas Instruments. The peer mentoring program matches a first-year student with a junior and senior ECE student. Throughout the first year, the student mentors serve as a resource to first-year students. Our office also plans a number of professional development activities throughout the year for both mentors and mentees. Thank you for your time. If you have questions, please feel free to contact us via email at ECEAdvise@umd.edu. You can also visit our website at ece.umd.edu. Also, be sure to follow us on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook.